I will show you a bit what we can do with Ableton Link and MindMapper 3.2. So now if I start MindMapper and just create a quad and apply a stroboscope on it, actually I can check the BPM sync option here, and then it will use the BPM that is here. If you are not using Ableton Link, you can choose to make manual BPM, where you can tap to give the BPM, use the audio beat detection or a MIDI clock. And if you check the Ableton Link button, then it will be on the BPM of Ableton Link, which can be shared among multiple MindMappers or with other application or with Ableton Live. So actually I have Ableton Live, so if in Ableton Live I set my BPM to 130, it gets 130 in MindMapper, and the invert is correct too. So here it just changes the BPM in Ableton Live. So if I play, I've got just a small track with drums, and I've got another track where I put some curves. I can send actually here to MindMapper input here, and that I can use also as controls. So here now we can see that since the BPM is coming from Ableton Link and BPM sync is checked on my strobe material, it's just perfect. So there are a lot of things we can do with it. I already made a demo somewhere with materials demo MindMapper 2.5, something you can find on YouTube. No, I made a small file with a lot of things that I found fun to do with matters. So here I will show you a bit. So that the Siren material that I'm using here with BPM sync active, and I put that on two quads, taking the same part of the material, but one is flipped. Here I've got some shapes. So if I just okay, I've got two quads here using the shape material, and for the ones using another instance of the shape material, but here where I put the number of shapes to 8, so I can make even more. And this is doing each 2 bits or something. It's actually looping in 2 bits. So if I increase the speed here, I can make it loop 1, 2, 3, 4 each bit actually. Okay. Here, that's the material, Mexican waves. Ah yes, that one is not. Is it online? I have no idea in fact. Let's go to the material online library. Mexican wave. It's local. It's not. There's someone who made a GitHub with it. I can publish it. It's fun. I cut the internet connection. So you can use this one also. Yep. Okay. So actually this one is a small material, it's fun. I assigned some MIDI controls to each parameter, and that's actually the curves I made here. They are controlling each value, and that's what's doing the sinus effect. That one is shape control, it's also in the online library. So basically it's just a way you can control a shape, make a cycle of some size, defining the stroke, and the smoothness. And you can do square, triangle, circle, or hexagon. So if I can just make one cycle, duplicate this shape control material, and on this one I will put a cycle and make a triangle surface, duplicate that one, oops, and choose triangle, and now there is an automation effect that is BPM synced. Well, I finish with a demo, so right, and then with this loop, with this shape, I can choose a stroke and I can choose a repeat. And if I animate it, this one is the tuto damper. It's a, basically it's a, it was a tutorial. It's a very simple material that is using a damper filter. And the damper filter. Actually it just takes the value here and it applies the damper on the output, and the value just moves the line vertically. And if I change the damping values, that's a damper. That's a kind of filter. And if I use this one, then I made a MIDI control so that the CC number 11 actually controls this slider. It does fun things. So the CC 11 is this one. This one is the shape morph. This one is the rotating axis. Nice one. This one is line animation. This one is the shape generator that is also online. Horizontal scan. H scan, it's an online one. So also has a BPM sync option, the shape repeat one that you can also turn into a triangle or a cycle. Change the radius. So all of those small animations are actually supporting the BPM sync. So if I just show you everything, and the fun thing with all those materials is that they always run at 60 FPS, well, until your computer can handle all the things you are doing, it's always running at 60 FPS.